always a problem with war, especially when you've had a war which has sent people abroad for so long. They come back, and some of them don't. Maybe their time is up in the military, or they want to move on to something else. What do they do? How do you? What do you train them to do in a non-war environment? Poppy Harlow's in New York. She's got more on that story for us. Hi, Poppy.
Hey there, Allie. Well, you know, everyone's battling this incredibly high unemployment rate, but what we found out in doing this story is that the heroes are our men and women that fight for this country in war. When they come back from war, they have an incredibly hard time trying to find any job, needless to say, trying to find a solid employment situation. So we met one of these vets who actually is being helped through an extraordinary program helping put these vets back to work. And, you know, just this statistic is amazing. Almost a 12% unemployment rate is what we have for vets that have returned from war since 2008, a big problem in this country. We're going to tell you about a program that is doing a lot to change that. Take a look.
Brian's story has been phenomenal. Self-employment, entrepreneurship, going out and starting
a work after serving for so long.
It was probably one of the toughest.
So Haney set out to change that.
That's the aim of this program. Passion is the number one criteria.
Oh, as hard and as difficult as it was, it'll never, ever be as hard and as difficult as combat. Like, that's the beauty of perspective.
Certainly, perspective is everything in his story. You know, that documentary, Allie, it's going to be in theaters in New York and L.A. in the fall. And that $100 million feature film they're making, that's going to be released in 2012. Brian is pretty optimistic. He even hopes that he'll be nominated, maybe, for an Academy Award. But when you talk about the program that helped him do this, it's almost all privately funded, Allie. They have not really gotten any government aid, Allie.
Yeah, and you know, franchise, Terry, and now you run a business partner.
No, and that was really what we found out during the story. I said, why isn't the VA or the DOD funding this? And the founder, Mike Haney, said, look, we've been trying. So we really pressed the VA. It took me about a week to get a solid answer from them. But what they said to me is, look, we strongly support the mission of EBV, of this program, but unless they develop a per-person billing system and get approved by the VA, we can't fund them. Basically, Allie, it's a bunch of red tape. The good news is they are now looking at EBV, and they may fund this program. So at least the word is out there. We'll see if they can get some government money.
What a great answer. Okay, Poppy, thanks very much. Good to see you as always. Have a great weekend. Hey, I'll be in New York next week. I'll see you there.
We'll see you then.
All right.